Hi everyone, it's Zoe from the Scratch team, also known as Zinnia. Today I wanted to show you how I draw really simple backdrops in Scratch. Adding a backdrop to a Scratch project has this ability to really set the scene, and I have found that there are really simple ways of drawing an effective backdrop. So that's what I wanted to show you today. Let's get started. To draw a backdrop in Scratch, just hover over this button that says Choose a Backdrop and click Paint. I found that a good base for drawing a backdrop is to create two rectangles of different colors, one to be the sky or the wall, and the other to be the ground or the floor. So if I was doing an outdoor scene, I would probably do a blue rectangle for the sky. And the way I would do that is click on the rectangle tool, change the color to blue, and drag out a big rectangle. I usually click here to edit the outline and make there be no outline on the shape. And then to make the grass, I will set the color to green and drag out another rectangle sort of on the bottom. And then once I finish the base, I like to add one item in the backdrop. And I usually like to create this item with either the circle tool or the rectangle tool. So what's something that could be in an outdoor backdrop? I could add a rock to it. So if I click on the circle tool and set the color to gray and then drag out an oval and click on this tool to edit the points of the shape and move the bottom point inward, yeah, that looks like a rock. And I could even change the color slightly and make another smaller rock next to it. And there you go. That's a pretty simple backdrop and it's really quick to make. So for drawing your own backdrops, one way you can start is by thinking of two colors for your scene. If it's an indoor scene, it could be a yellow wall and a blue floor. If it's a city scene, it could be a brownish reddish wall and a gray street. If it's a scene in a spaceship or a secret hideout or something, it could be a light gray wall and a dark gray floor. And then you can think of some small object or detail to add with the rectangle or the circle tool. A flat brown rectangle could be a shelf in a house. And you could even put a square on top of it, and then that looks like a vase on the shelf. Some flat rectangles of a slightly different shade of brown could be bricks on a wall. A light blue rectangle could be a window in a house, and a dark blue rectangle could be a window in a spaceship out to the night sky. One particular type of object you might want to add is a plant or a bush or the leaves of trees, and I have found for this that the paintbrush tool is really helpful. So if you have this color set to green, you could click on the paintbrush tool and just draw sort of squiggly rough lines. They don't have to be anything in particular. Make some squiggly shape and fill it in with the fill bucket. And then that could be a bush, you could make a plant, you could even make sort of the canopy of leaves at the top of the forest, which could give the idea that your scene is a forest scene without you having to draw every single tree. For any object that you'd like to have a rough edge, I definitely recommend experimenting with the paintbrush tool. And lastly, let me show you how you could get started with a top-down backdrop, a backdrop where your project is seen from above. What I'll do for a top-down backdrop is just do one big rectangle for the base ground, and then just draw paths with the paintbrush tool set to whatever color I'd like the paths to be. And you could even use the circle tool or the rectangle tool to create shapes that would be seen from above. Anyway, there are so many ways to draw backdrops in Scratch. I wanted to give you some ideas that could give you inspiration, but you can take these ideas in any direction you want. See what you like drawing and what works for your characters and your projects. I'll see you next time, and Scratch on!